Hi, I'm Janet Devlin.
Janet, it's fantastic to have you at the MediaSkin Gifting Lounge. You've been enjoying the event this morning.
Yeah, it's really good fun. Yeah, amazing.
There's lots of great products here. Is there anything in particular that excited you or interested you as you've been looking around?
Oh, wow. There was definitely some hair products there that were really, because my hair's kind of dying as I dye it more and more ginger. So it's definitely really, really good. It's specifically for curls there, so that's cool.
And are there any particular products, beauty products, cosmetics that you swear by?
Whew. I'm so bad at that because I'm not really like a girly girl that knows much about makeup or anything. But I definitely have to say moisturizer, like just any moisturizer that I can get my hands on. So, yeah. I just finished recording my album and it's out now, and so I'm preparing for a tour, which I'm doing now around the UK, which starts off on the 1st of December. And then in the new year, I'm heading off to America because I just signed a deal there. So that's cool.
We're very excited about the new album that's out. For anyone who hasn't had a chance to listen to it yet, can you just give us an overview of what the album's all about?
It's about my life. It's all come from like my journals. So I've always kept a journal since I was very young. But all the material, all the songs are based around songs that have come out of there. Little poems and little snippets and things. So yeah.
And is there one track in particular that means the most to you personally?
Yes, I think the last track on the album called Whiskey Lullabies was one of those ones where I was like, in session, I was like, I don't know if I want to write about this, but it's because it's very personal, but I did anyway, and it really paid off because it became a lot of people's favourite song as well. So,
I mean, what is that track all about? I mean, you say you were a little bit nervous about writing about it.
I've kept the metaphor pretty hidden in there, so I'm going to let people listen to it and figure it out for themselves, because lots of people have different meanings for it, so I don't want to just give mine away. So...
You're about to go on tour. Do you enjoy that? Obviously, some people prefer being in the studio. Some people prefer being in front of a big crowd. What's most comfortable for you?
I don't know. I do. Like, everything is different. I mean, being in the studio is great because it's like a nice, creative, fun space to finally get things that have been rattling around in your head finally in sonic form. But I do love performing live because I always hang around at the end to meet everyone, and it's quite nice, especially if someone's like, oh, I'm this person on Twitter, I'm this, it's like, oh, I finally got a face to your name now, that's really cool. So I always hang around and talk to people. It's really, really cool just to finally meet them. Well, there's a girl called Michelle Doherty who's just absolutely amazing, and she's been such a, like a heavy supporter of mine since the start. We have a guy called Andy Rodriguez who came all the way from California for a gig of mine in London. That's pretty cool. I can't, now I've gone blank with names. Oh yeah, there's a guy called Ravi who is like, beats me to like any news. Like it's like, oh, Janet, will you put that on your socials? This really cool thing's come in. And I'm like, I'm so excited to put it up. And like, I'll go on Twitter and he's already beat me to it. I'm like, how do you do this? You must have like Google alerts. I don't know, but he's a legend.
I mean, you've got some great fans there. You mentioned someone flew all the way from America just to see you. You're obviously going back the other way now. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, well, I just signed a deal with Radical Records in the States. So hopefully going over there in January time just to start, you know, showcasing. And there's already, like, fans out there. So if I do a showcase or do some gigs, there's going to be people there, which is going to be great. And a lot of Americans are, like, part Irish anyway. So it's pretty cool to get that kind of connection back. So...
Will there be a new album then, I guess, with Radical? Is that something that you're going to get working on straight away?
I think, well, first of all, we're going to release Run 'Em with Scissors because we haven't actually released it in America yet. So we're going to release that. But I'd love to do some writing when I'm over there. That would be great because there's some really great writers over there. So I'd love to.
Are there any American artists that you'd love to collaborate with?
Oh, my gosh. Devendra Banhart. He's pretty sick. Yeah, but he's all the way in California, so... I think I'm going to be in New York, so I don't know if I'll be able to do any of that. But there's loads of people. I mean, I'm always up for a good collab.
And my very final question. Have you got a message for fans watching this all around the world, particularly people who love the new album?
Oh, thank you for loving the new album. I don't know. Thanks for caring.